As we know that there are 2 ears in the human body, 2 ears for hearing and 2 tympanic membranes. Once we take the tympanic membranes of both the sides, they will be looking like this. Tympanic membrane of the right and the left, which I am drawing. So this is the right tympanic membrane and this is the left tympanic membrane. How would you try to know this, whether it is right or left? Take a clock. L is equal to 11 o'clock. 11. Right side is equal to 1 o'clock. This particular handle of the malleus is at 1 o'clock in right tympanic membrane and 11 o'clock in left tympanic membrane. By this way, you can know which side tympanic membrane is it. Once you start learning this one, you have the idea of basic of the tympanic membrane on the right and the left. If we take them, let us take the right tympanic membrane or the left tympanic membrane. As I already told you, tympanic membrane is an oval membrane which is like a skin closing the entrance of the middle ear, which is the lateral boundary of the middle ear. So you can see the angle of the malleus in this particular thing, it is at 11 o'clock position. 11 o'clock position, therefore it can be called as left tympanic membrane. There is angle of malleus, there is annulus tympanicus, which is the rim of the tympanic membrane, which is all around. This is called as the rim of the tympanic membrane, it's called as annulus tympanicus. There will be a brilliant cone of light in the anterior-inferior quadrant. This particular thing is called as cone of light. Cone of light in the anterior-inferior quadrant. Cone of light in the anterior-inferior quadrant, which is the anterior-inferior quadrant. Anterior-inferior quadrant. There is the annulus tympanicus like this. Most prominent part, it is called as the umbo. The most prominent part is called as the umbo. Umbo of the tympanic membrane, UMBO, umbo of the tympanic membrane. And then these two, wherein you could see from the handle of the malleus, they are radiating anteriorly. They are called as anterior malleolar fold and posterior malleolar fold. This is the anterior malleolar fold and this is the posterior malleolar fold. This being the left tympanic membrane, this will become the anterior and then the posterior one will be the other side. This will become the posterior of the left tympanic membrane. So, these are the important landmarks. The other important landmarks which you could see, as you should notice, is this particular upper part above called as pars placida. Pars placida. Wherein there are only 2 layers of the tympanic membrane in this pars placida. The lower part which is tense, that is below the malleolar folds and above this one, is called as pars tensa. Pars tensa. Pars tensa has got this particular cone of light. Pars tensa has got cone of light. And then, once if you take, this is the handle of the malleus. Wherein, how can you see the malleus if the bone is transparent? bone is transparent, this would be the head of the malleus and this would be the end of the malleus, looking like this. And what else are there in this particular part? If you take the incus will be, as already told, this is pars placida, and at 11 o'clock, as you could see, I am just erasing it off. This should be the incus, it means malleus should be along with the incus. So this is the aortic region wherein you can find the incus will be like this in this model. In this model, this will be the incus. This will be the incus. And the third thing, most important thing, smallest bone is the malleus, this is the incus, and this will be the stapes, which is present like this. If the tympanic membrane is very thin, you can see this incus, long process of the incus, and this is the stapes, as you could see over. And you can also see the tympanic membrane is very thin. You can also see the chorda tympani now running from posterior canaliculus to anterior canaliculus towards the infratemporal fossa. This particular outer ring is called as annulus tympanicus. You take just this annulus tympanicus. So there is a deficiency of the annulus tympanicus, which is called as notch of Ribenus. This particular notch of Ribenus, I call it as notch of Ribenus, it corresponds to the aortic region which is just a dangerous area. Aortic region is a dangerous area of the particular tympanic membrane. To take the layers of the tympanic membrane, this pars placida has got two layers. Placida has got only two layers. Tensa has got three layers. Placid has got two layers. The middle layer is not much developed. Okay, tensa has got three layers. Externally, epithelial layer, middle is the fibrous layer, and inner one is the mucus layer. This fibrous layer has got three types of fibers: radial fibers, circular fibers, and parabolic fibers. This particular layer is not that developed in the case of pars placida. A perforation in pars tensa is called as safe perforation. This is a safe perforation. Perforation in the case of pars placida is an unsafe perforation. This is the basics, quite basics of the tympanic membrane, which you are about to see in a human body. If you are liking these videos, kindly share and subscribe. This is Dr. Smailbel Verbal from India, Dr. S.B.V. Chandrasekhar Smailbel Verbal from Hyderabad, India. He is of ENT. Thank you very much for liking the videos and sharing and subscribing.